You want me to start here?
You're going to sit there. What okay. I'm saying is, we're going to play like an introduction. You'll come in with this.
Okay, after the introduction.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll just play a little bit.
All right.
Okay.
So just do something better. Well, just tell, can you like just cue me when you want me to come in?
You will know it.
Okay.
Start playing if you start up. He's going to start louder. Then it goes down when you're ready to come in.
Okay.
A little introduction, a little whatever.
Feet on this American soil, the artificial beauty of its landscape shall be clouded with haunting weeping, sadness forever. 'Tis no escape. I make a prayer to return to homeland of God's intent for me. True Congo. My heart be in mournful weeping for all the chocolate-colored souls who be in our love-filled embrace. In the quiet nighttime of my sleepless dreams.
Thank you.
pleasure to prune. Thank you. Nicholas Morrow, Arthur French,
and Marjorie Elliott.
Thank you. Thank you.
and the moon was not yet asleep, and the sun was not yet ready to open its eyes in greeting. At the tip of the river's edge, where the crickets sleep on their bed of moss, the sunflowers had an unnatural sway. Papa, look! Look, look, Papa! Look, stop the boat! Pull alongside, I shouted. The teasing flickering of the moon lit her eyes. The girl we would come to know as Elfie was staring at me, her face framed by the yellow blossoms. Blossoms canary bright, like the sun. Papa heeded my plea. He looked at Elfie with a knowing eye. She motioned us deep into the jungle thicket. Elfie made rapid fire whispers to Mama and Papa, then sprinted away. Papa held us close and was gone, as if there had never been Papa, and would never again be Papa. Mama kissed each of us with unhurried rainbow sweetness. Baby Ari rocked tightly to Mama's breast, wrapped in her gunny sack, laughed and played with the raindrops as they pelted across her glowing chocolate face. Mama pulled us along this narrow stretch of swamp road, lined on both sides by tree-high sunflowers. A tiny speckle of light from a wintry moon splayed across our frightened faces. Mama's eyes were pools of tears, shaped like stars. Her legs moved with the sure-footed, majestic grace of an eagle in flight. A sweeping mixture of fear and determination. The rain was raging in a whirling dance of such anger. The wind was leaping and bounding, slicing through us with bold precision. The death rattles make of noise. Congo blood floweth with the passion of ancient rivers. Elfie had made rapid-fired whispers to Mama and Papa, then sprinted away. Papa held us close and was gone, as if there had never been Papa and would never again be Papa. Mama kissed us, each of us, with unhurried rainbow sweetness. Baby Ollie, wrapped tightly to Mama's breast in her gunny sack, laughed and played with the raindrops as they pelted across her glowing chocolate face. Mama then pulled us along this narrow stretch of swamp road, lined on both sides with tree-high flower. A tiny speckle of light from a wintry moon splayed across our frightened faces. Mama's eyes were pools of tears shaped like stars. Her legs moved with sure-footed, majestic grace of an eagle in flight. The rain was whirling a whirling dance of such anger, the wind leaping and bounding, slicing through us with bold precision, the death rattles make as much noise, Congo blood floweth with the passion of ancient rivers.
Grant Chapel African Methodist Episcopal Church. The fancy sign carried this sense of African arrogance. The music held me captive in its own hypnotic language. Every Sunday I'd watch the callers, fancy dress, fancy speech, march across their divine threshold with such an air of grandness. Young and old, singing and swaying to the rhythmic charge of this pure, unadulterated sound. Papa did not truly care that I took a liking to the prancing and carrying on of the dark people. My dear Mama had no say at all. What harm could come to me from the life of them? I stand neath the glowing colors of the sun-drenched, steeple-shaped windows. The brown-eyed girls and the brown-eyed boys make a prayer chant. Their words are most surely not for mine hearing. This entrance of celebration into their holy house, lyrical and sweet, harmonic feast, ancient tongue of the darkened ones. 'Tis no common thread between us. Yet they maketh my heart smile. I feel a measure of emptiness, hollow loss. Why? I stand in the shadows, bearing witness to their African salute, in thanks to the gods for their great suffering. Why am I here? Doth there be lessons of learning and redemptiveness in my path as I make a crossroads with their much heralded Congo dream? Why? Their church houses go up in swirling flames. The steeples splinter. Holy books floating in man-made pools of devil water. The music never stops neath the splintered ashes. Thank you.
Thank you. Next week we'll celebrate. Have a good day, everybody.
That's it.